Hey, happy Thursday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. And I'm going to give you the latest tropical update on what's going on with this still potential Gulf hurricane that could be coming, or could it be going towards the southeast of the lower 48? Or could it actually go towards Central America, maybe towards Mexico and the eastern Pacific? You see, we have Tropical Storm Bud. It did form for this morning. This is no threat for anyone. It's definitely over there for Hawaii. But you can also see we just still have all this dust that's still sitting there. Matter of fact, we have a big plume of dust that is moving through right now, and we have potentially another one coming also. Now, what's going on with these tropical waves is it has to move in between these plumes of dust. So what you have is a big plume of dust. You got a wave. You got a big plume of dust. And in between these dust pockets is where these waves are actually trying to form while all this propagates to the west across the tropics. Now, the last couple updates has been showing some very concerning with the Euro control member, even showed a potential major hurricane once again going to the Gulf of Mexico yesterday. So I'm gonna show you all your latest information as far as today, maybe even some good news. We gotta see what the trends will follow for this afternoon. So let's get right into the information. Thank you all so much for the likes yesterday and all the nice comments and all the help and the donations that has been sent. Thank you so much. I do appreciate every single one of y'all. Now let's get into your information. If you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe, make sure you click that bell so you do get the updates. Because what I'm seeing is we're supposed to be going into a La Nina pattern, and I believe we're going to stay a little bit longer into the El Nino pattern. They're showing it was over in May. I'm showing it could be hanging around all the way to the end of July, maybe even the beginning of August. Now you can see the latest potential velocity anomaly with the GFS. As we go into August, everything is going to start ramping up. But once again, you can see where our region is going into the Western Caribbean, and then into the potentially the Gulf of Mexico. And this is all sliding a further little bit to the west, where it'd be either Western Gulf of Mexico or maybe even going into the Eastern Pacific. You can also see the latest update with the Euro showing the same thing, favorable environment moving through. But you notice that the favorable environment for our region for that potential Gulf hurricane, Gulf storm, is a weaker element, and it is more believable towards the Eastern Pacific region for maybe better development of these storms. Now, I updated this on my community tab yesterday that these storms were going to a different point. We even saw a stall in the update yesterday. So you can see the update for today. There's three general directions that this wave can go through after it reaches about 6 or 7 days from right now from today. Now you see the latest information on the Euro in 6 days. Our tropical wave confidence is moving towards the Leeward Islands, the Northern Islands in the Caribbean. And you see as you go towards 7 and 8 days, still showing confidence. It has gone down a little bit, but still showing up to 30, maybe even up to 35% confidence of at least a tropical depression to form as we go into August 2nd, then August 3rd. Look how it hits a brick wall right here. This is that potential stall. And as you go all the way to 10 days, consists to push forward after that, but then it starts spreading out. Then it starts spreading out to three different directions. It can either go into the Florida, into the Western Gulf, or into the Eastern Pacific after that, potentially. And if you look at the latest update that Spectrum News put out from your favorable environment, you can see all this has shifted right off of the Caribbean islands. Look at this. All that favorable environment is here is gone. Now it's showing your best chances to get formation will be late in that direction. Now, when we check our chances for a tropical cyclone probability, you can see it also has grown. It has grown all the way to 30%, even maybe a little bit more of 30% chance as this goes all the way by the Eastern Caribbean and potentially towards the Bahamas and then whatever it does into the Gulf or slips into the southeast of the United States, the lower 48. Now, this is all the way to August 5th. Now, as we go a little bit further, all the way from the 5th to the 12th, you can see there is chances for that to form up into the northern Gulf of Mexico, maybe even slip around the southeast of the lower 48, and still maybe go into the eastern Pacific. We still have formation in the eastern Pacific, regardless of what this tropical wave does, but still, we could have multiple. Then after that, that's where it's supposed to get historically more active as you go towards the middle of August. This is where formation forms a little bit sooner and maybe curving around towards the southeast, the east coast of the lower 48. So as we look more into the ensembles of the Euro, you can see right here by the time you go all the way towards August 2nd, showing that wave will start off very weak and potentially could strengthen up still and go right towards the Bahamas by the time we go to the 3rd and 4th and maybe going towards the southeast by the Carolinas by the time we go from the 4th through the 6th, or maybe be late in the western Gulf of Mexico and maybe forming up there if it don't go into the eastern Pacific. And then maybe a wave that comes right after that could also start forming up where we historically see it form up the middle of August, by the time we go towards the 9th by the Bahamas and curve around as well. Still have a wide array of what the possibilities can still be for this wave, but we are starting to see a little more of a trend of a westward push, and I'll show you why. You can see the latest with the Euro ensembles showing maybe upper level low going to the Gulf. The high pressure is still expanding out, maybe forming over here right where we're seeing this tropical wave as we go around 7 or 8 days away. When you look with the Canadian, it shows about the same thing, a little bit further to the north. The GFS don't see any of that. It pushes everything into the eastern Pacific on an expanding high pressure. Now this is going to expand and retract back. It's all about timing. GFS takes it a lot faster. Euro takes it slower, where it takes a few more days to travel, and that's when it's saying it will open up. So when you look at the latest run as you go forward, you can see as you go all the way to the 10-day mark, you can see maybe the intensity could go around this high pressure, or it could remain one of these weak waves pushing through. So it's right in between the dust plumes traveling. So either it slowed down and the dust caught up with it and just got to the core and no precipitation, it cannot form, or it's speeding up and it's catching up to the dust as well. But showing on the latest run that it will remain weak longer than expected, and showing as it goes to the west, still could get a late formation into northern Gulf of Mexico. It would remain weak until this time, still seeing that upper level low putting shear on it, and still maybe go westward into the Gulf of Mexico as well. Chances for all these to form into the eastern Pacific as well. And then after that, maybe more formation. Matter of fact, we're seeing maybe another big plume of dust could be coming off, and that quiet August could be happening. Now, when you look with the Canadian, you see it goes around the high pressure, still showing something strong could intensify. A stronger storm would push further towards the north, and showing it still could remain weak, still showing maybe going to the Gulf of Mexico as something very weak, maybe something stronger later. But it is trending that that will remain a weak area because of potentially this dust. The high pressure is retracting back though and letting waves swing in this direction. And the GFS just pushes everything to the west, saying that high pressure is going to expand early. Still sees that potential late formation around the 4th through the 6th. And that's it. That is it. Showing that this big high pressure swinging everything around, according to the GFS, will be expanding and growing during that time and not retracting back like we're seeing a little bit with the other ensembles. Now this right here would put us right into August, the first week of August, still with a big high pressure pushing to the west, showing still potentially a big plume of dust could be coming off the coast of Africa. This would mean that we would be staying in a El Nino phase, not a La Nina phase. The waters are still very warm in the eastern Pacific. They're not cooling off just yet. And you can see this as you check your sea surface temperatures. As you go towards the end of June, you've seen that below average kicking in the eastern Pacific. This is what you see as you start seeing it cooling down in the Pacific, and above average, a warming up in the Atlantic. This would signify we're going into La Nina. But if you watch, as we go through July, it's starting to warm back up again. It's losing that cool down where usually you don't get formation as much over in the Pacific. And it would warm up in the Gulf, in the Atlantic, in the Caribbean. Showing with the GFS that could happen and still build a big monster of a hurricane right along the coast of Mexico. Now this Not showing it would turn anywhere east or any of that, but this could potentially bring a lot of rainfall and precipitation and storms towards the western side of the lower 48. So when you look to see what's new and what changed, you can see as you move in 7-8 days away, you can see the tropical wave right here. You got the high pressure expanding out. You got the high pressure still going west on the lower 48. And as that goes to the west, look how the high pressure stays expanded in the latest model run. This is only the latest. This is not trended multiple times in a row, but it shows this, and it also shows that we have a trough coming through, which plays a factor as well. But watch how that wave keeps getting revolved to the west, because that expands. It loses its time to go in. The trough comes on in, and the high pressure expands and keeps pushing this to the west. This is the latest run. Remember, the last few runs, it's been showing dramatic opposite. So until this trends, I'm not going to put my guard down. But what I can say is I took it pretty much in my head from a DEFCON 3 down to a DEFCON 2 factor. And if I see this trending even again for today, definitely go down to a DEFCON 1 and preparing for potentially for a very weak August. Look, even that next one, potentially going west as well. Big high pressure right here revolving around would protect Florida. It would protect the southeast. Still got iffies about maybe the western Gulf of Mexico, but still showing maybe some protection is growing with that high pressure right there. So whoever's putting the prayers up, great job. I think some prayers are getting answered here because this is something new. And matter of fact, if you look at this and you see exactly where it's at by the time you go to August 3rd, 1 a.m., you can see the trough, you can see the high pressure expanding to the west. And if you look at the previous run, this was way further to the north. The high pressure was retracting back. There was no trough. So this is all new information right here. So if this trends again, I'll let you know. If this trends again, then we can really think that August, potentially the rest of that information could be correct as well. Could be going to a very quiet August. GFS sees it as well as that little weak vorticity, little wave right there while we get in formation in the Eastern Pacific. And you can see with GFS agreeing that that high pressure would swing it into the Gulf. You see that? It would still go into the Gulf, but it's still going to be suppressed by the dust. So GFS is seeing the same thing that the Euro has been showing, that it still will go right into the Gulf. Matter of fact, the run last night showed that major hurricane go right by the Panhandle of Florida. GFS is seeing the same thing, but it's also seeing a lot of dust, a lot of dry air getting around this wave, and that's why it can't form, is because of the dust. Now, when we look at lower level dynamics, you can see that we actually have our tropical wave moving right by in 5 to 6 days. We can also see, according to the Euro, you have all this dry air around it so that the big plume of dust caught up with the wave and it's keeping it weak, dancing with it all the way across. So literally, this is where we are at, still at a 10-day marker with a big plume of dust moving right behind it. Also, you can see almost the same thing with GFS. With GFS takes a lot less dust with this, and as that moves to the west, just shows it expanding high pressure, but the dust is going to just hang around with it as it goes. Still tries to form up something into the northern Gulf of Mexico. Still could be a group of disorganized thunderstorms. What we need to still watch is late formation on that. And you can see the next tropical wave coming right behind this one. Now we're moving towards the August 6th factor. So now we're getting into the first week of August, and the next wave could potentially have the same problem. A lot of dry air and a lot of dust. And look at all this coming behind this, showing that after that plume of dust, there could be another huge plume of dust coming in while we're trying to get these big waves in August. Look at this. Another big plume of dust, a lot of dry air coming in, and these waves still can't do anything. Look at that, is a huge plume of dust. If this were to still continue to show true, we're talking August 10th, still tropics would be shut down because of this much dry air. Which brings us right back to this again. So you can see the chance for that formation is still there. A lot more formation moving towards the western Gulf of Mexico into the eastern Pacific. We still have this we need to watch for it, but there's also a front-induced low that could be in the northeast. Could tap into some of this energy as well. But look at this, still showing that that dust potentially could be coming to buy, just like we're seeing also with the GFS. From the 10th on, a big plume of dust potentially could be coming in, bringing unfavorable conditions, sinking air instead of rising motion, and we could not start literally until the very beginning of September. And this right here could just be a group of disorganized thunderstorms. That's a latest information. That's not a fact yet. Neither is a Gulf hurricane. We all know how this works out. We see what's going on the latest updates and trends, and we just keep updating. The trend so far is showing potentially the dust will catch up with this wave, keep it weak, keep it suppressed, potentially the next one as well, and move further towards the west. Still seeing some formation into the Gulf of Mexico. This would be potentially a group of disorganized thunderstorms that may intensify at the last minute right before landfall that we still need to watch for. That has not gone away yet. The latest update on the Euro that just come out, literally still 6 days, that tropical wave be somewhere around here by the Leeward Islands. Still a group of disorganized thunderstorms, still showing no vorticity on that group of thunderstorms, and maybe still the dust is suppressing it. Still showing that the high pressure, look how it expands with it. The high pressure is expanding with it so far, and it's going to be a continued dance towards the west. And that trough is still there, so we will see. The trough is what pulled Beryl north, but this trough is too far to the north. It's a short wave trough, not a long wave trough. And this high pressure expanding with it could steer it towards the west. This is where we're at in 6 days. I will keep you updated. And that is the latest update. Thank you for your time, everybody. I will keep you updated. Hopefully this trend holds and continues. That would be nice. We try and practice safety as much as we can on this channel. That's why we do this as much as we can and keep the updates rolling. That way we know exactly what's going on as we go through our hurricane season. Tell me what you think down below. Would you like a whole August, a whole month of August? Just nothing. Now remember, we still got these storms that's going to be training from eastern, southeastern Texas into Louisiana for today and still for tomorrow, still training these storms. So you still got to watch out for chances for that flooding. You are in that moderate level risk all the way towards Texas and Louisiana for today. It's going to be a lot of storms still. Hope y'all have a very great day today. Hope this information hopefully put a little bit of a smile on your face to see how things are finally going with a crazy start like Beryl. If you remember, that's how Euro started. It started off crazy with Beryl. It started off crazy on this wave. So we'll keep you updated. Euro is not expensive for no reason, so we will see what the latest information will be. And before we go, just a little quick reminder, Psalm 4:8. I will both lay me down in peace and sleep, for thou, Lord, only makest me dwell in safety. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. Keep your prayers up. Prayer for other people. Make sure you help as much as you can. The greatest thing I love is just make sure you help someone today. If everyone just does a little bit of that, what a great place it would be, wouldn't it? Think about the days you need help. Imagine if someone was there to just anonymously just give you that help, give you that little nudge. We all know it comes from the Spirit. Remember, all glory goes to God. Our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope He keeps you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Please, Father, keep this hurricane season quiet and to the west.